The fun part is all about moving sliders and checking checkbox to customize vehicle. Run scene 2, car setup scene. Hide or delete old vehicle if you had one and pull new one. Well, we got a small Polo hatchback here. Save scene if you want. Press the play button and get ready for magic. The customization process is 11 setup pages. First page is a transmission type, front, rear or four-wheel drive. For this hatchback, I set front, of course. For this small Polo hatchback, 75 or so horsepower is good value. If you want deep and precise adjustment, you can also change the motor power output curve, but we don't need it now. Low maximum RPM is more suitable for this kind of vehicle. Inertia is speed of rotating engine to simulate something like fast motorcycle engine or slow diesel engines. Next page is gearbox. Choose here automatic or manual gearbox you want. Also, you must specify referred shift RPM for smart automatic gearbox. Smart means it won't shift gear while trying to burn out, doing some donuts or perform a drift. I want automatic gearbox. Next page is brake section. Braking force is difficult to measure, so I decide to measure it by the size of the brake discs. Second slider is a brake bias. Sometimes you want to make your rear brakes more effective than front. Pretty big brakes is okay for this vintage Polo hatchback. On this page you can adjust the maximum steering angle of wheels. Good steering angles is about 35 for cars with front wheel drive and less than 40 for rear wheel drive. But for some cases, like drift and stunt vehicles, you can make it 75. 35 is enough for this. Muscle vehicle. Think there is no need to explain. Let's set the value to less than a ton. Next is aerodynamics. It's air resistance coefficient and two sliders for front and rear spoilers. Each spoiler gives you downforce for each axle while cornering, but make you lose top speed. No spoilers and average air resistance for this car. Now it's suspension section. A suspension distance of 16 cm is good. Also, it should be pretty weak with low down. Next section is wheel camber and tires pressure. Negative camber is for racing cars and especially drift cars. Positive camber is suitable for heavy loaded pickups and heavy SUVs. The high pressure makes steering more sharp and react quickly to steering wheel turns, but the tires losing grip a little bit sooner. For this vehicle I won't know any camber angles, and 2.2 is good pressure. Rear last section is electronic helpers. We need no helpers like ABS, traction control or stability control system. Yes, we got a steering wheel or a gamepad as controller. Now you may see the current settings on right side of screen. If everything is fine, click the test button. So here we go. The tachometer is marked according to your RPM settings. For fine-tune, you may use telemetry data like suspension distance, wheels, RPMs, G-force and forces dealing with tires. Swap the camera to get a better view to see how suspension works. If you are not satisfied with the result, click the back button to change the settings and then click the test button again until you are completely satisfied with the result. I like accelerating corner, but I don't like suspension. It's too stiff and looks like modern hot hatchbacks, but my wheel seems like old one. So click back and change the suspension settings. Fine for me. Stop play mode. The vehicle's done. All customization data is already saved. All you need is export prefab to your own project. Yes, so fast, fun and easy. But let me show you tuning in a different way. Let's take not an abstract vehicle, but a vehicle from real world. This one. Now, let's search the internet for any data about this car. Here what I found. Well, it's time to copy this data to all our sliders. Does it seem good? Yeah, good. But is it fun? Not enough. Now we change it to a drift car. We need to make it over 400 horsepower. Change camber to negative 6 for front axle and negative 2 for rear. Do we need change automatic gearbox to manual? No, because there is not just automatic gearbox, but super artificial intelligence smart automatic gearbox. It will never change gear while doing some stunts. So, rear drivetrain, over 400 horsepower and negative camber is all you need to drift on a quiet heavy car. Let's test. Fine. Quit now. In the next and last video, I will show you how to export a prefab to your own project. That's all. My name is Boris Chuprin and thanks for watching.